So I love maps, and I have to pull up my. Where did it go? There it is. I love maps. And when I was a kid, I was the designated navigator on all of our family trips. So before we started the trip, I would peruse the map. I would plan out our route. I would figure out all of our stops. And during the actual trip, I would be sitting in the shotgun seat giving my dad directions. I have been replaced by the very mobile technology that Jeremy was just talking about. But that's a good thing because that device, that GPS device, does a much better job than I did. And if it were not for my GPS, I would have had a much harder time finding this place on my drive down from Philadelphia yesterday. My name is Gerald Aungst. I'm the supervisor of gifted and elementary mathematics for the Cheltenham School District, which is right outside of Philadelphia. They've given me 6 minutes today to give you a 3-credit graduate course in assessment. So I figured that probably the best way to speak to a group of educators about that was just to give you some examples, to give you some specific things that you can chew on and things that you can kind of consider as you are looking at how you might transform your assessment and revitalize your assessment with digital tools. So learning is a journey. And on that journey, just like those family trips that I was talking about, we need to think about three things. We need to think about where we're starting. Where are the kids at the beginning of the process? We also need to check the map and the itinerary along the way to make sure that we are, staying on course and staying heading towards where we need to go. And we also need a way of knowing when we've arrived at our destination. And in the learning process, assessment is our GPS. And I think you heard through all of the earlier presentations, assessment was a thread that each one of them mentioned in one way or another. Digital technology changes the way we think about and the way we use assessment, and it goes way beyond having your students take the test online and use, do the test online. So what I'm going to do today is just share with you a few, very few tools and give you some quick ideas about how you can use those tools to transform assessment in your classroom. So to know where your students are at the beginning, we need to do some diagnostic assessments. And I'm going to share with you three quick tools that I like to use for that. Evernote is a tool that I use for digital portfolios. I use it myself all the time. And it's, if you're not familiar with Evernote, it's kind of like a digital filing cabinet. This is what the iPad version of it looks like. And it's just a place that you can collect literally everything and anything that you want all in one place. I recently visited the Anastasis Academy, which is a school outside of Denver, Colorado, where every student in the school has an iPad, and they use Evernote to collect every single bit of work that they do all year long. So the kids are doing a lot of work digitally in the iPad, but anything that they do, paper and pencil, projects, they take photographs of that and capture that in Evernote. They also will record video and audio reflections, and they will record each other doing presentations. So everything goes into that Evernote. And as a formative assessment tool, you can look at the beginning of a unit at what your students have already collected in their portfolio, so you get a great picture of here's where they are right now. Students can organize their notes and their clips in notebooks, and it will even tag the notes with where that note was taken, so you literally get a map of where the learning has taken place. And it's a great way for students, if they've been on field trips and things like that, to kind of get a picture of where they've been. Another tool that I like for formative assessment, or I'm sorry, for diagnostic assessment is Google Apps. Create a simple form in Google Apps, have your students do a survey online, and the advantage over paper and pencil is everything's collected right into a spreadsheet for you. The data's there, the data's organized, and you get an immediate instant snapshot of where your students are. Another one I want to share with you is called Poplet. This is a mind mapping tool. The reason I like this one is it's dead simple for students to learn and use. You can have them at the beginning of a session say, okay, show me everything you know about this, and they can do it visually in Poplet. So along the way, we need to also keep track of our progress, know where we are. On my drive down yesterday, at least three times, I missed a turn and heard those lovely words, route recalculation. And I was really grateful for the fact that the GPS had my back, because without that, I probably would not be standing up here right now. Again, Evernote, and you're going to hear this again, Evernote, during the process, you can see their work in progress. You can see the drafts. You can see the kind of messiness of their process. Jeremy also mentioned Poll Everywhere. If you don't have clickers in your classroom, clickers are a great tool for quick formative assessment. Give your students a poll, give your students a quick question, and just get some very quick anonymous data about how they're doing. Poll Everywhere is a site that you can use to do similar things without clickers. Think about tools that you don't normally think of as assessment. Imagine if you have student writing, and rather than saying to this student, you use the word like too much in your writing, plug it into Wordle, and it visually shows them that like is the biggest word, and therefore it's the most common word. So some unusual tools. Think about ways that you can use tools like that for your assessment. So we also need ways of finding, are we there yet? You know, what's the summative assessment when we're at the end of the process? Okay, again, Evernote, collection of everything. Two other tools that I really like, and by the way, this is hardly an exhaustive list, just to give you some quick thoughts and examples. If you're not familiar with the site Learnist, check it out. It's kind of like Pinterest for learning. And what I like, what I like about this is students can collect different things and kind of do that curation that they were talking about earlier. Collect different things, put them together, and show you what they've learned. It's a great visual and digital way to do that. Think about also some of the great digital storytelling resources that are out there. A fourth grade class in one of the schools in my district recently used Comic Life as a summative assessment for a project that they did on folktales and fairy tales. And so rather than giving them a test, the students actually created their own stories to show what they understood about it. This is one example of a comic book that they created. They took their own photographs, they put it all together into this fantastic story, which obviously you can't read it as I'm flipping through the things quickly, but you get the sense of what they did with it. And it was just a phenomenal way for them to synthesize all of the learning that they had done. So obviously that was a rapid fire thing, and some of you are probably saying, what was that quick, what was that? So what I've done is I've collected all of these links plus a few other ones at my website, gerldaungst.com/presentation/DLDay13. My contact information is there as well. If you're interested in more, please do get in touch with me and check it out.